Recording has started.
Hi everyone, welcome to this new session. Today we're going to see a little update on JupyterLab requirements. So we released version 0.5.0 and we introduced some new features and we solved some issue. First of all, there was the problem in the cluster that we wanted to handle because when if the one resolution fails, there is a pipenv that can be used. And in that case, there was an issue with the cache. So we decided to have a look at that. And Frido suggested to modify basically one environment variable. And now that is part basically of the of this new release. So now we should not have that problem anymore related to pipenv. But in any case, related to the other two features actually are something that is related to Invectio. So Invectio is able to basically analyze your imports and libraries that you're using in your code. And we use this library in JupyterLab requirements now to identify the packages that are in a notebook. So imagine if you have never been using JupyterLab requirements and now you want to start. If you open your notebook with some dependencies, from libraries that are importing in the cell, then JupyterLab requirements using this library from Invectio is going to show you what library you should install. And we're going to see an example in a moment. And the other feature that we introduced is something that was missing before. But now when we basically ask for an advice, we also provide more information to our advisor in order to receive a better recommendation. And this is also something that we do using Invectio. Let me show you what I was talking about. There were also some fixes related to the runtime environment because we also store which runtime environment was used to provide the dependencies. So in this way, we can also tell the user or warn the user if a specific software stack, for example, has been installed not with the TOT, then the software stack might be not optimized for your runtime environment because you don't know which, it was not used by, provided by TOT, so that is not an information that you can get, but the dependency will be stored as well there. So just as an example, this is just a notebook that we have, and if we have a look at the dependency, at the notebook metadata, there is nothing related to dependency. So this is a notebook that we created some time ago, and now we want to basically install the dependency so I can share this notebook with someone else. So now if you just do basically manage dependencies using the extension of JupyterLab requirements, you will see that the message will tell you that there are no dependency found in the notebook metadata as we checked, but TOT using the new the library Invectio is able to basically parse your notebook and identify the packages that you you need to install. And then you can basically just install the dependencies and then your notebook will be ready for you to use. I can submit the advice, but maybe it will take some time. Let's call it demo. Yes, we can have a look, I think, here. So as you see, the stack has been submitted to TOT, and if you have a look here, this is something that was not present before because we were not submitting the analysis of the code, and now we are also doing that. So these are information that we provide to advisor to give a better recommendation for us.
And showing something other than the Jupyter notebook?
Thank you. I'm sorry about that. Thank you very much. I forgot about that. Yeah, sorry. Can you have a look at this? Yeah. So what I is just the log for JupyterLab, and as you
larger,
can see, basically
larger by five times. I guess.
How to do that?
Control
yeah,
R
yes.
plus maybe.
Done. So as you see here, this is the stack that I was showing you. So the one that was identified by Tot using the Invectio library, and now we are submitting it to receive an advice. And here I was showing that we are also performing static analysis now because Tot is using also this knowledge from the code that you're using in order to improve the recommendation. And meanwhile, when we wait for this, you can have a question, please. Otherwise, I finish with the demo.
So the Jupyter Lab extension is now basically doing what Tamos has done on the command line before, right?
Yes. So yes. Now we are nice. Providing also that functionality with this new version. So
okay.
Yes.
Cool.
We're going to provide better recommendation to users.
Better than the command line?
Yes.
Good.
Any other questions? Otherwise,
thanks for the demo.
Thank you very much. Bye.